What's up, guys? We're here again for another gameplay commentary. And if you're wondering why I'm trying to speak loud, I'm trying to practice that thing. And I think we are, instead of a one-on-one, we will be looking at 3v3. So let's introduce you to the players, but first let's just see who are allies with one another. Blue, red, and green. Okay, so let's do that. Team A is blue, red, and green, so that means our map arrangement will be like this. So let's introduce ourselves to our players. Green Britons, Kabaka, rated 1146. Our Spartan blue is Sav XC1. Come on, give my life a break. And come on, I cannot pronounce Red Romans. This just yeah, the factions only. And here we have the other team, Team 2, playing as the purple Macedonians, sky blue Spartans, and another Macedonian, which is a yellow. So this is a match between the Greek factions and a little bit of a much more diverse faction set of Celtic one, a Greek one, and the Romans. Okay, so this is the strategy being employed. Gatherers. I think I lost my track now. Sorry guys, it's been a long time since I've done this before, and I'm kind of a, you know, especially in that we're looking at a little bit of a 3v3, and what kind of strategies can be employed right here? Well, maybe we can see where. Usually when there's a team game, there's usually this what you call the rusher, the one who attacks players early on in the game, while somebody else tries, what do you call it, the money player, or the guy who booms a lot. So while somebody's rushing the other teams, the other one will be teching up fastest to the city phase so that he can attack with stronger units while keeping the other team at bay. But seems to me that that's not kind of a strategy being employed here, although we can see the attributes of that, because the guy with more women tends to want to boom faster to town phase, while the people with more cavalry, they're the ones who prefer the rush style, or because there are a lot more animals. And see that even the Britonic faction has an extra hunter within the ranks, which is the attack dog. Now, so by the looks of things, the Celtic faction is the Russian-ish.
Yeah, see?
The Spartan will be the boomer, and the Romans, I don't know. He seems to have both attributes of a hunter and, no, seems to be a boomer as well. Well, let's see about the other team, our Western team. Macedonians, boomer. How about our sky blue? Somewhat booming aggressive, because you don't usually start with the barracks early on. You should spend that wood for your decent population count. And especially if you're Spartans, because you have a population, what do you call that? Some term that opposite of bonus. Okay, so whatever that term is, yeah, the tip of my tongue. And oh, a corral. Oh no, a farmstead. And yeah, the boomer mass, I mean the rushing Macedon, and the booming Macedon with a Spartan, I don't know, I'm not sure. But of course we can see here the typical strategy of storehouse near to a very good patch of trees. Even although I think I actually prefer this one, it's more safer, more behind your base. But whatever your strategy is, closer to your potential military, that's good. And here we are, our first raiding party of the game, going against our Roman player who is unfortunately trying to boom his way. So that means this rush, especially with the spearmen, it's going to be very effective against our Roman player here. And how many women he has taken down? I think that's only one, although the one and two women, three, make that three, four. And ooh, that's a good job. So that means our Macedonian player is keeping the economy at bay from our Roman player. Yeah, he is doing a very good job because every woman are inside, even the cavalrymen that red has, can't actually do anything against our purple player here. Yeah, let's just consider that purple. And okay, he stopped the raid because he was his enemy was paused to delay his economy a little bit more, even though he's closer to town phase than I think even our Spartan player here. Yeah, kind of ironic though, the guy who was about to tech pocket. Yeah, that's a good job, Macedonia. Keep your opponents at bay. But of course, if you're the only raider here, you might want to raid other people. But I think raiding Rome is quite a good job for the most part, because if Red's allies don't help him soon, this guy might be fall behind, especially in terms of phases. And here we have a little bit of farmstead getting captured, getting deleted, and although it's getting deleted, Rome has eventually inching his way out of our Macedonian player here. And how many? 10 Roman cavalry against 8, so that means Rome is managing to defend well and getting even the slightest form of economy. He can do that, okay? Although it's understandable that especially earlier on, Blue has the responsibility to assist his near ally. That means he will also kind of delay some of his economic units just so he can help it. And here we have a counter raid, because come on, Macedonia, you can't do a raid without me, you know? Okay, so that means we have a little bit of a raiding duel on the bottom side with the map. And I thought yellow was trying to help there, kind of failed. And I think green is also trying to prepare that as well, even though, yeah, that was a very successful beating away of your opponents. And too bad he didn't actually see this. Why? Yeah, it's kind of protected though, so understandable. So that means these cavalry units are more dependent on their mobility, so that the men down here won't be able to defend as much as they want to. And at least these farms are relatively safe, even though Rome is slowly regaining himself, slowly getting back up. No matter how slow that would be. So he needs food, a lot more food than he wanted to, just so he can tick up to town phase. And by the looks of things, nobody's even there yet. Oh, except our Western Spartan player here. Okay, so which factions are in town phase? Looks like only that Spartan player from our left side there. Yep, he's the only one with a bigger territory radius, so that's... Uh-oh. So while Rome is planning another raid here, and it may be a counter raid. You can use that term. And Rome, the guy who has better microwing skills can handle these raids much better. And I think Rome is handling it much better because he has managed to pull his units away and protect his own base. And Macedonia... Yeah, booming quite decently, even though he's not managing his raiders here quite. I think he's not doing it as much as he wanted to. But hey, this base is not as protected as Macedonia's. I mean, he's booming faster though. Yeah, 200 food left and 400. That means, hey, where did your... Oh, here we are, looking for the weak spots. And I think Rome will kind of be in trouble here. So that... Oh, here we have a little scout. Okay, but the action's right here. So sorry, I got distracted right there. So this is a very good strategy for you guys planning with your team players. Whenever you have someone who's specializes in raids, use him while the other two manages to boom. I mean, come on. I think yellow has managed to take out the town phase. Green, not there yet. Yes, not there yet. Yeah, blue, not there yet. Rome, obviously not there yet because of his lack of food. And, oh, he made it. He doesn't even... Oh, that's because someone sent him some... He needed help. Well, that's one way to assist your teammates. If you can send your units to your base, you can pay tribute. How do you do that? No, not here. It's in the diplomacy menu. Let's just take this blue, for example. This is the diplomacy menu. And you can send... I don't know why you can send some things to your ally. I mean, enemies. I mean... This can work if you are a multiplayer, maybe. If you're working on multiplayer, that can work. But against the AI, doesn't work. I mean, that's just how the game works. And, okay, here we are back to our raiding players. Red doing some raids, and I think, yeah, blue ready to join up to wherever Red will be raiding here. And even though... At the cost of him still delaying his phasing up. And Macedonia, I think he hasn't done that yet because he's the slow. Yeah, if you're the raider, you have a risk of being the slowest to tech up. Understandable. And here we have a double teaming up of blue and red against purple, getting that revenge reads up. And of course, two against one, this is going to be quite of a micromanaging headache, especially for our defensive player. And as you can see here, Rome is somewhat ready to raid our Macedonia player here. He's somewhat, at least, made the defensive formation, ready to respond to this sample raider here, and still managing to take down some women. Oh no, that was a man. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm counting the units. Kind of a good raid. Was it a good raid? I don't think so. For now, let's just evaluate that these two are kind of doing a good job because they realized, I think, they are falling behind. Oh, that's great. Tech up to town phase, man. And yeah. Who has not tech? You're ready. Red, I think he's there. Yep. Macedonia not there. So this is the imbalance happening right here. And of course you this is kind of an advantage for purple, if you want to consider that, defending against the raids, just so your allies can actually boom faster than you. And especially market going up for our Macedonian players. I'm not sure how well they can actually... Oh, some fallen soldiers right here. Nice formation, Sparta. And two barracks formation too. Our Celtic. 1, 2, 3. Aggression. Although, I think you're... Yeah.
Yeah, see?
No, not a slinger rush. I don't know what to rush. I think it's... some sort of city phase rush. And I think these two players, our red and blue players, don't know who to raid actually. Although strategy wise, our western team would like purple to be raided at all times, but it seems that I think red and blue has seen through that strategy and they're planning to raid their booming player. And what is blue doing while all this is happening? No markets going up. Nothing's going up. You're not trying to boom. Only your Celtic factory is kind of decent. I can manage that. But so far, two players are trying to soak up the damage that our more aggressive team are employing. And if you're considering this thing, I think the aggressors have a little bit more of advantage because the more defensive team are forced to respond while that is if there is happening in our aggressor's base. I mean, The only one improving we can see here is our Celtic faction. He has more houses, clumped up here, houses here, barracks there, while our raiding parties only have barracks, a few basic defensive units, and Rome, which is almost empty. I mean, he's just going for all-out raid if he can, but he's so far behind. Even if he is in town phase, functionally, just look, these are all village phase buildings. Everybody else has practically improved. I mean, even though this Macedonian player here at the bottom still isn't in town phase, so to speak, he's still more populated. He has a more steady economy. I mean, compare that to Rome. He needs resources from what's this? People are assisting each other. Even purple.
Yeah, see.
In the state that he's in, he can still offer some resources to his teammates. While, so this is kind of the difference we can see here. Rome, this because of his raids, needs assistance from his teammates. Well, whereas purple, despite raiding and being raided, he can still offer tribute to his teammates to strengthen that. So that means whatever strategy being employed here, strategy wise, okay, let's just use that term, strategy wise, our Western team have the advantage. And when it comes to teching up faster, I think our Celtic faction will be there first. But who's to judge? You can see here that one building for the stone. Yeah, you're getting there, you're getting there. But you can't deny that the Celtic faction is more established, more ready to pump out more units than any of our Greek factions here. Yeah, there's a barracks here and a barracks here, but not as many as our Celtic one. So that means these, oh, what's this? Sorry about that, guys. So trying another raid, trying to keep Rome at bay, and blue, so what was it? Yeah, these two players are backing on the strength of this player. So Sparta and Rome are depending on the Celtic strength. He will be checking up the town city phase soon. Well, not even our opposite team will be ready for that. Okay, so tech wise, technology access wise, our Eastern team have the advantage, as long as the other two players can keep distracting everybody else in the process. So while that's happening, Rome's trying to recover still whatever village phase or town phase buildings he'll be building now. We don't know. I mean, this is quite empty if you ask me. And yeah, we will be waiting, I guess, for our Celtic faction to do something about this. He's the only one really ready to make something happen while this is happening. Okay, so Hoplite sending your own economic units to war against the cavalrymen, but however, it's not like our Macedonian player is not ready for that. Come on, we only give you wood and you do not like it. That's what you get for sending wood. We don't like your wood. We already have some wood. We don't accept your offering. So that's what we can see with our blue player here. He tried to distract to no avail. Still in village phase though. Great distraction still. So as our wood patch, blue's wood patch is going to run out here, he's soon have to search for one. He has a lot of them. Well, market's good enough. Not really. You're still too dependent on our green player here, who's slowly inching his way to our dangerously getting close to our Macedonian player here, who is less equipped to fight. Okay, so, whoa, two civic centers. That's kind of a risk there, and taking out just city phase. Okay, so you built another civic center just to slow up yourself down, but is that a mistake? Can that prove to be a mistake? I mean, come on, I know you're trying to get some metal and some more resources. That's just what I see there. But is the cost worth it? That's just the question. Especially that neither of you are actually prepared to whatever green has in store. Okay? And Rome.
Yeah.
Quite the defensive player that he is. Still using that turtle strategy. His build is really more of a resist, soak up the damage, and make sure, and yeah. If these guys keep thinking that, yeah, we're winning because this guy will not be able to do anything, that's not necessarily the case, especially if you are not watching out for the other player that you have not yet seen, I think. Have any of you seen what Green is doing? Not even close. Well, Yellow can see that, but I don't think everybody is aware of what Green can actually do to each of their bases. Kind of a very interesting game, right? I mean, the advantages, imbalances that we can see here is being played out. The imbalance here is that Rome is the weakest being employed here, but the trade-off there is that Green happens to be the strongest, and even though most of the Western players know of Red's weakness, they have they have very little knowledge of Green's strength. So what are they going to do if ever that happens? And I think Yellow is feeling that pressure from Green, especially, I think this is, hey, a cavalry? Okay. That doesn't usually belong to the Britons. It's the Gauls who have that usually. But yeah. But here we have the Slinger Rush. The Slinger Rush. Well, it's not like Macedonia doesn't have its own set of slingers, but and Green has more slingers in store in here. And not to mention the support units coming in here, yes. And the hero ready to barge in to take down each of the citizen soldiers apart. Although I think it's not doing that successfully, still, this is a battle by numbers. And if, yeah, here comes backup. But although I think it will be kind of too late to help Yellow out now, there will be some buildings that will get taken down. And is it a mistake to leave Green alone? We will see. And what's the question here for Skyblue? Will he counterattack or respond to the attack? Well, counterattack meaning create. I think he's being forced to respond to it now, especially now that there are battering rams. Yeah, poor Yellow. That's all I can say. You left Green alone for the sake of Red. Red's okay. That's what I can see here. Okay, I have to harp on that, especially that this is, let's just say, unprepared speech, because yeah, I kind of admit this is one of the replays that I didn't watch first before commentating, because I just want the chilling factor, because who will win this? I want to know who will win this, okay, along with you guys, if you did not watch this replay prior, okay? So that means we will be seeing who will win this game first. And if you're wondering, yeah, I know how long this game will last, because In the replay, there is a description of how long this game lasts. Except for the spoilers, I don't give that, I don't want that. Okay. So it's about 26 minutes, so... yeah, there are 6 minutes left in the game. And if you're watching this on YouTube, of course you know how long my video will last, so you know whether this will be the winning fight or not. But seems to me that either green will fall or yellow will fall. So judging by the game time and the action being dealt here, I think this battle will summarize the whole game. Okay, but I think green has all the advantage he has, especially now that the slingers are in elite rank. I can tell because of their shields. Although why does some of them have round while some are square? I can guess that I think the round are the elite ones. Yeah. If they're wearing square shields, that means they're only in advanced rank. And the elite ones have the round shields, as well as the white hair. Okay? Brown hair for the basic rank. Golden hair. Okay. So yellow gets taken down. And I think this is basically the game. And all we are seeing here is a steamrolling of the strength of green. Come on, man. That's kind of a disrespectful thing to do, building a base after you rank the one. So this is one of the main reasons why you prefer capturing, because you don't have to take the enemy's building down and then build your own, because it's faster that way. But playstyle against playstyle, and especially I think he didn't want a Greek civic center, he just wanted a Celtic one. Okay, so everything will follow here. Everybody's just going to do the old invade your base. Uh-oh. Sky blue here. Yeah, I think he's trying to help his yellow teammate here, and until he saw this one. And we will have a battle of whether the civic center will go up. I don't think it is. By the looks of things, especially that blue is trying to focus fire. Yeah, it may not be getting up, at least they are being sacrificed at the cost of it. Okay, but there are still some citizen soldiers and pure citizen soldiers trying to slow the death process down with this. Hey, and hey, look, it might be going up too. Just because their Sky Blue's forces are going down faster than these guys can build, and they are losing badly. Okay, this is a losing battle, and I think Sky Blue realized it, so he shifted his focus from the civic center to the citizen soldiers, and yeah, Blue is forced to respond to that, and uh-oh, here comes Green, here comes the hungry, no, not hungry cavalry, but, huh? Unsatiated slingers, whatever. They just came here for the attack. They came here for some blood, and come on, man, you should give up. Counterattacking doesn't work anymore. You either have to respond to this, or you are going to lose now. Especially that you have to realize Rome is here for the sake of resilience. It's the chosen role of cursed again. Whatever, I'm not even going to try that. Yeah, it's made to soak up more damage than it can chew. Assist in delaying the attack against all the other players. And what do you do? Leave these guys alone. Okay. So that was a very tough skirmish on Sky Blue's part, but I think this is dictating the whole game now. Right? Although at first we did see some successful raids, that was just a ruse strategy-wise by our Eastern team. It was just so for this strategy to work. The money bank player I still can't load the whole area. Yeah, that civic center went up. So here we have our territory lockdown. They're getting pushed back into a corner. Okay, back down in a corner. Just like a rat in a trap. And this one, this time the rat does not fight. It can't fight even if it wanted to. Yeah. Okay, fortress stroke. What? Yeah, he's a Spartan player. Makes sense. Because I forgot he's a Spartan player, but even if the defensive formation of those buildings will not help now. Especially the slingers, how that crush damage that make them effective against buildings. Okay. So this is where everything just falls apart. So yellow, because yellow was not well defended, didn't boom fast enough, and green was booming faster than any of the other players, even if they were assisting red to survive every onslaught that our western team. Come on, another one? Have you no mercy? So this is what's happening. Green is attacking, blue is building. One is what's this? I approve sending stone, food, and metal. What are you in for? You're already in city phase. What do you need? I think the Skiritai Commandos, yeah. I think the Skiritai Commandos is what you need. Yep. You need food, wood, and metal, and you're selling all your reserve resources and basically just trying to fight it off. Our western team are just trying to survive for as long as they can, even though the game is basically over. Right? We can all agree. The moment that yellow was overrun, even though he has his second civic center, that proved costly to his side, because even though you have so many barracks now, that won't help. Whoa. Macedonia's, and our purple Macedonia just resigned, realizing everything just wasn't everybody. Yes, resigned. Okay, yellow, even though you're the first to go, first to go down, you're the last one to resign. Really? Okay, so we will be just be watching. Never mind. Okay, so that's how our game went down. Very nice strategy by our Eastern team. Nice strategy by the Western team, although it proved to be kind of a at least plan of our Eastern team. Come on. Macedonia and Sparta's raid, I think Macedonia is the only one that raided Rome. Counter-raid by Rome, and he sucked everybody else in there, and blue came to assist here, while the two bottom players were relying heavily on green, trying to use the booming strategy. Oh, look, stables. That means he used the farm animal strategy, because gathering meat is more effective than food, and by the time he was attacking, yellow's base wasn't prepared enough to wasn't strong enough to resist green's attack. Everything went downhill. So this strategy is kind of great. Very risky, but great. So congratulations, Western team, and there we have it. So that's it. We have our game for our gameplay commentary. Okay, and this is the Amphibian Hoplite. I'll just call myself that, even though I want to be called something else maybe later on. I'll just stick to that name. See you guys next time.